This video covers the basic principles of Tekla model sharing. Tekla model sharing works with all versions and configurations of Tekla structures, starting from version 21. Tekla structures is available in different configurations that provide specialized sets of functionalities to suit the needs of the construction industry. Tekla structures can be used to cover the entire building process from conceptual design to fabrication, erection, and construction management. Model sharing is available with all configurations. You don't need to install anything extra, just go to the file menu in Tekla Structures and select Sharing. To start using Tekla model sharing, you naturally need a Tekla Structures license first. To use Tekla model sharing, you need a personal Trimble ID that is connected to an organization account. The organization must have a company license for model sharing. Your company's Tekla admin invites you to your organization and gives you the right to use model sharing. Users consume available company licenses, and additional licenses can be purchased as needed. Model sharing licenses are released 3 hours after session is closed. When working with a shared model, the modeling and editing takes place offline. An internet connection is needed only when you want to submit your changes or download changes from others. Tekla model sharing is not compatible with multi-user mode. When switching from single-user mode, you need to select which one you prefer to use for collaboration. Model sharing brings you superior performance, change management, easily scalable team setup, and radically lower network requirements. When using model sharing, only the changes need to be transferred online, not the entire model. A baseline contains the entire model. The model owner typically creates the baseline once a week. When new users join the model, they only need to read in the latest baseline and then the packets after that. Model changes are collected to packets. The packets are light and very fast to download and upload. After you make changes to a shared model, you submit your changes for others and receive the changes they have made. Typically, you want to do this a couple of times a day to keep everyone up to date. So, how does it work in practice? In this example, we have two users, Olivia and Noah, working on the same Tekla Structures model with each other and other project members. First, both users work with their local models offline. Next, Olivia does a read-in to receive changes from other users, and then writes out to share her changes. At this point, Olivia's local model is up to date, and her latest work is available in the cloud for others to read in. Noah is now ready with his work, and wants to submit his changes for the team to see. Noah first reads in the changes made by the team, and can then write out his changes. At this point, Noah's local model is up to date, and the changes he made are available in the model sharing cloud for others to read into their local models. You now know the basics of Tekla model sharing. If you only have a few minutes to spare, continue by watching some of the other model sharing videos. They are short, a couple of minutes each. If you have 30 minutes or more, we recommend you go through the model sharing e-learning course. The course includes all of the short model sharing videos. It also has additional material, such as knowledge check questions.